Let's start with question number 1B, the concept of base levels. What is the question? Explain the concept of base level. The moment you are supposed to explain the concept of a particular entity or a particular topic, you have to take a holistic view of it, right? So in introductory part, the role of base level, that's the way we have discussed about the importance of a topic with respect to subject. So base level concept is very important. In the evolution of, in understanding the evolution of landscape and has been intensively used by various geographers. Especially Davis and Ping. The concept was, anywhere you can begin. This may be the second, the concept was given by J.C. Powell. So you can create a better introduction from the basic concept. Now the concept of base level, you can define here also. What do you mean by base level? Some of you have a very clear statement about base level. What do you mean by base level? End product is a landscape. Base level is slightly different. The max, that's where we are committing a mistake. It is about concept of base level. It is not about what base level has been treated by Davis or by Pink. Question is not mentioning about that. So you have to explain through your thought as well. What do you mean by base level? You can't confine it to rivers. Base level is associated with various erosional agents, not sea level also. Right?
Below which the erosion ceases to take place.
Ceases to take place, yes, erosion. The base level is ultimate level. The base level is an ultimate level till where the erosional agents are active. The ultimate level till which the erosional agents are active. Here you have taken a different view than what is presented by an individual, because it is not, the question is not asking you to write about the Davisian concept of base level. It is simply discuss the concept of base level. And you have several examples, like for example wind. Base level of wind is not sea level. It is the water table, right? There are several base level which is far, far below sea level, 400 meter below sea level. And a very good example is Jordan River, Dead Sea. So you cannot confine in your introduction a particular aspect of concept of base level. You have to give a very diplomatic statement which covers almost entire aspect of base level. So the moment we say that, it is the level up to which erosional agents are active. Everybody knows that. Those who have written, some of you have written very good answer as far as the content is concerned, but hardly have got 5, 5.5 marks out of 10. It's basically because of this that you didn't touch many of the aspects, which you all know. I'm telling you gradually that you all know those concepts. What are the factors which will change base level? But you have not mentioned that properly. So erosional agents are active. Now the moment you have suggested erosional agents, in continuation, which will bring coherency in your answer, talk about erosional agents. Different erosional agents have different base level, right? So base level is dependent on, is largely dependent on the type of erosional agents. However, it is studied mostly in the context of fluvial base level. Right? Even in the case of fluvial base level, the base level may differ depending upon the ultimate point or where the water ends. Right? So in the case of fluvial base level, the most common, never write permanent. Permanent is again given by Davis. That's why book writes. The permanent base level is sea level. What do you mean by permanent? What about the inland drainage system? The moment you talk about inland drainage system, sea level will not be the base level. It may be below sea level, it may be above sea level. That's what you call regional base level. Global base level, again, never talk in a static term that sea level is always the permanent base level. That is again given by one individual, which is you are not supposed to mention that. Like that, you are not supposed to follow that rather. You can mention it, but you can criticize as well. So the moment we say fluvial base level, the global base level, which is achieved by most of the rivers, is sea level. Right? Here itself you talk about, there are possibilities that sea level itself change, hence the base level may change. Right? There is eustatic changes, isostatic changes, which causes sea level change. So with the change in sea level, that itself is not permanent. How can you say that sea level is permanent? So the moment you say that global base level is sea level, again mention here, since there are greater possibilities of sea level change over the period of time, base level gets affected with that. For example, during the Pleistocene period, the sea level was much lower and the base level got reduced. Right? So you can mention here the Pleistocene Ice Age in the nutshell. Just in one go you can talk about that the sea level change and associated impact on base level. Right? Then you talk about the regional base level of fluvial. In regional base level, we'll talk about generally the inland drainage and tributaries, the base level of tributaries. The base level of inland drainage may be below sea level. For example, again, Jordan River, Dead Sea. Now, I'm telling you how to write, you have not read examples which you have never read. You can give example blindly. You must have learnt the lowest point of a continent all of you must have known. Which is the lowest point of Africa? Lake Assal. Lake Assal, the lowest point will generally be below sea level. Lowest point of a continent will be below sea level. The moment we say Lake Assal is lower than sea level, so you can give example, if you don't remember the name of a river which is entering into it, the moment it is a lake, there must be at least some streams entering into it. You can give example here. Streams entering into Lake Assal. Baikal, Lake Baikal, the deepest lake of the world. Even if you have never read it, you can give example here. So talk about that, which the rivers are the streams which have base level lower than even sea level, maybe the one which is entering into Lake Assal, Lake Baikal, etc. The base level for tributaries is the water level of master stream. For example, the base level of Yamuna is the water level of Ganga at Allahabad. Right? Then, local base level, generally associated with the waterfalls, rapids, neck point, etc. The base level of this will be determined by the steepness of slope. If the slope is very steep and available amount of water is sufficient enough, it may erode much lower than the sea level. That's what you call temporary base level. With respect to time, they may change because of infilling will result into again a gentle slope over a period of time that will be temporary base level, which will be eroded because of the hydraulic action of water. Right? So that temporary base level will be associated with some landforms locally present. Right? Let's say formation of a very steep waterfall in the Himalayan region. So because of its steepness and the kinetic energy in the water, so the erosional capacity will be very high, so it may go much deeper into it. Right? Now you have talked about it, talked about the possible effect on base level other than the normal. The possible changes in base level due to other factors. The other factors and possibility or possible changes in base level. All of you know it, rejuvenation, right? Climate change. Just write in brief. Talk about anthropogenic activities and change in base level. This will be especially associated with dams.
Dredging.
Desiltation process. Deforestation will lead to huge amount of infilling and sedimentation, which might reduce the erosional capacity of a river. So local base level, temporary base level, and regional base level might change because of infilling. So that you can talk about in a nutshell. If you have consumed enough amount of word in the first aspect, you can write it in just one line or two lines. The base levels is basically a dynamic concept which can keep on changing because of rejuvenation, climate change, and anthropogenic interference. Khatam kar diya. Yes.
that.
Yes, karst topography, again you can give example. In the limestone region, the base level might be much lower than sea level. It's basically because the karst level, the underground water is active. That's why I'm saying when you are talking about that, if you have enough amount of scope, when we are talking about the fluvial aspect, you can talk about wind. What is the base level of wind? Water table. Water table of that area. Wind will keep on eroding. What is the base level of underground water? Impermeable rocks, impermeable hard rock bed topography. Generally, it will be coastal water, it will be similar to that of fluvial, that is sea level. Glaciers. Lowest point of an area. Of that area wherever glaciers are found. It has nothing to do with sea level. If lower point is maybe lower than sea level, glacier will keep on eroding. Because its physical movement has to be guaranteed for its erosional activity to be continued. Yeah, definitely. The not lowest point of that particular continent, because generally the valley glaciers or the mountain glaciers are active as far as erosional agent is concerned. The continental glaciers are generally get transformed into fluvial aspect as far as the base level achievement is concerned. So when you talk about glaciers, you exclusively talk about the glacier and its achievement of the lowest level of erosion. The moment it is melting and it becomes river, then you have already covered that. Right? So glacial is basically so long the slope is available, so that will keep on cutting. So the lowest point of that particular slope will be the base level for glaciers. Now even if you roughly cover 70 to 80% of this, you will get 7 out of 10 marks. And I don't think those who have written good answers do not have any such information. The only problem is that your mind must reflect variety of aspect. You should learn how to think laterally under the pressure in the exam. When you are writing test, write it very, very seriously. And try to seriously, in the sense like you devote your 3 hours, even if you don't know, keep on sitting there. And try to think laterally. But take it non-seriously in the sense of your imagination. Because if you commit mistakes here, it will be a learning process. Right? So try to commit mistakes as well. Because if you commit mistakes, you learn a lot. That scope will not be there in the examination hall. So try to commit a lot of mistakes while imagining things, while generating lateral thinking, while generating several other points. So in the process, you will learn a lot.